Okay, so here in this main function we have this PWM initialization. When we call this function, we have configurations to set wave generation modes and then overflow value, interrupt, enabling the interrupt, and then finally giving the clock. So when we go ahead and run this code, we get a pretty successful. So we will load this code over this simulation and run. So we get a PWM like this. So here we can see our PWM comes something like this. So this is the PWM which is given to the motor.